By the end of this video, you're going to be a pro at making quick refrigerator pickled red onions. I'm starting with one large red onion. I'm actually starting with two red onions. I have another one because I'm going to make these other variations. So to start, we're going to cut the onions, slice off the ends, cut the onion in half from pole to pole, remove the outer skin, then cut lengthwise into thin slices. You're gonna need some heat-proof mason jars. These are 16-ounce mason jars. Next, you're going to pack your onion slices into your mason jars. And now it's time to prepare the brine. And then you're gonna need some vinegar, and you could pretty much use any kind of apple cider vinegar, distilled white vinegar, red wine vinegar. Now you're gonna need a little bit of salt. If you want, you could add some sugar, could use another kind of sweetener that you like, maple syrup, agave syrup. You could really play around with whatever you like. It's not a lot of sugar, but a little bit kind of balances out the tang that you're getting from the vinegar, so you might like that. Combine the water and vinegar. I use 1.5 cups each in a saucepan and heat to a low simmer. Stir in the salt, I used about 1 tablespoon, and sugar, 2 to 3 tablespoons if you're adding that. Now pour the brine over the onion slices in your jars. My 2 large size onions fills just about 3 16-ounce mason jars. If you make a mess, no worries, that's what towels are for. And now we wait. Allow to cool to room temperature, then put a lid on and place them in the refrigerator. You can enjoy them right away after about 30 to 40 minutes to an hour, or keep them overnight and they'll be really perfect and ready to enjoy. They get better as time goes on, so, and then you can enjoy them up to 2 weeks, but I doubt that they're gonna last that long. And again, be sure to keep these in the refrigerator because these are not shelf stable, these are refrigerator pickled red onions. And they'll add such a delicious boost of flavor and contrasting texture and that beautiful pink color. You can put them on top of crackers and hummus, burgers, tacos, sandwiches, avocado toast. It's gonna elevate your meal and just take it to another level. Have them at your next vegan barbecue. Like, really, the possibilities are endless. You're gonna love them. So I hope you'll try these and enjoy them. Let me know in the comments below when you do. And also let me know if you make some different variations and how those came out. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. They're really good on hummus and crackers. And if you're looking for a hummus recipe, check out my hummus recipe in the description below. They're so good. They add so much flavor. You gotta try these.